to the 100 odd stakeholders who are coming up over there. We have collaborated with the NIT Durgapur. They are giving us all the inputs for the knowledge sharing. We are already operational with the Common Facility Center with state-of-art machines, laboratories, which the foundries in Howrah were lacking. We were been always said that Howrah is a place for sanitary castings, but this foundry park would like to change this thought process, and that now onwards Howrah will be the place for the best of the castings. They will be giving the castings to the best of the engineering giants, not only in our country but internationally. I will not take much time. Nearly 100 stakeholders are there. Nearly 15 stakeholders are already been given the land of assignment. Nearly 10 stakeholders that started their job. Some of the stakeholders will be catering to the demand of the best of the international players. We have infrastructure of the international quality. We have developed road, drainage, stormwater, waterworks beyond 12 kilometers. We have got underground reservoirs. We have got 33 kVA substation. Not to wait for anything, tomorrow anyone can operate. We have got the total plan outlay of 900 acres, out of which 300 acres are already developed. We have got, as I said, completely dedicated ITI building, testing laboratories, information marketing, simulation process. These are the things which the Indian foundries, particularly the Howrah foundries, never knew. Just for information, a World Bank official who was in the city few months back for some other purpose happened to be visiting our park. This is what she remarked, I quote, "I have been all over the world and visited number of industrial parks, but never I have seen one of such magnitude and vision." We expect an envisaged output for the first year of commercial operation with the nearly 300,000 metric tons. By the end of the fifth year of commercial operations, nearly 500,000 metric tons. Envisaged investment of rupees 1,000 crore by 18-19, which will be increasing to nearly 5,000 crores by 2021. Employment potential, direct employment of nearly 10 to 20,000 people by 18-19-19-20, and which will go up with the indirect employment of nearly 50,000 people by 21-22. This is a very nutshell the success we have achieved till date, but we are not resting our laurels. Would constantly strive in the days to come to make it to complete as possible so that it stand out as a shining beacon in the industrial scenario in the state of West Bengal. I also take the opportunity to kindly invite you all to visit our project site and see for yourself the progress and fulfillment of our dreams. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. We have two more announcements to make. But before that, Mr. Bewal, if I could request you to hand over the possession papers to the three companies. Would you want to come and hand over to the three companies? Can you give me the name of the company?
I take this opportunity to request our ACS Sri Rajiva Sinha to hand over the assignment land papers to three of the stakeholders here in this August gathering. Mr. Girish Madhavariya of NIF Limited. Mr. Amit Saxeria of RRL Steels Limited. Mr. Atanu Seth of ADI Alloy Castings, BP Alloy Castings. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. We have two more announcements, and if I could ask Mr. Sanjeev Saran for his announcements, and it's quite an interesting one.
Thank you. Actually, I have to make two announcements. One, we are in the process of entering into an MOU with Government of West Bengal, where we will be financing MSME units on priority basis. And second one is that we have decided to finance minimum 5,000 crore rupees during this calendar year to MSME sector. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Can I now request Mr. Sudarshan Gaur from, Sudhanshu Gaur from Allahabad Bank, who has an announcement to make. Yeah.
Eminent panelists on the desk and respected guests, good morning to all of you from Allahabad Bank. Allahabad Bank, you know, is the oldest public sector bank since 1865. And being one of the major bank headquartered, one of the three banks headquartered in Calcutta, we think it is our right as well as duty to extend our support to this MSME journey. We are also entering into an MOU with the state government today for financing the MSME units. And also from 15th onwards, it is mere coincidence that all over Bengal in phases, we are having MSME camps which are going on. And we think there will be a very impressive figure in at end of this, and all the pros and cons of financing has already been explained by Honorable ED of PNB. So I won't dwell on much. Thank you for your time.
I'm sure this announcement will make a huge difference to the growth of MSME and the sector in West Bengal. You know, as we come towards the end of it, I would now request Mr. RK Chajjar, Director. He's the director with Vikrant Forge and co-chairman of the MSME subcommittee for his vote of thanks.
Good morning, everyone. It is my honor and privilege to be standing here in this August gathering to extend the vote of thanks to all the eminent panelists sitting on the dais, and it's quite a difficult task for me to conduct that for the mere simple reason that the panelists have been so very forthright and upcoming as what needs to be done in West Bengal so as to become the full powerhouse what we used to be pre 40 years back. So we are all geared up to do that, and the Department of MSME, headed by Mr. Rajiv Sinha, the ACS, he has been the pivotal force to bring MSME to a fore, that it is being taken note of it. And as one of the panelists suggested, that we are one of the, West Bengal is the fastest growing MSME sector in the country. I start by extending my vote of thanks to Mr. Samson Khao for his very extensive discourse on the customer experience to the engineering. My vote of thanks to Mr. Ashish Vaishnav for making us aware that engineering is in the DNA for the city and for West Bengal per se. And he mentioned about Sandesh only. So we'll not, if you have not had Rasgulla, I would suggest that you have one today. So that you realize how Rasgulla is better than Sandesh. Of course, that is my personal choice again. My vote of thanks to Mr. Samson, Mr. Saran, EDPNB, for his commitment of extending credit to MSME sector, and also to Mr. Sudhanshu Gaur of Allahabad Bank to committing financing MSMEs in West Bengal. And MSME is one sector that if finance are timely available without getting into the nitty-gritty of asking for collateral, then I'm sure, and which of course Mr. Saran mentioned in his remarks, that it will not be required, and that will be a great favor to the MSMEs in the West Bengal to come up and put up their units. My thanks to Mr. KP Anand Gopal for his enlightening us that 20% year to growth is positive if we continue to grow the way we have been growing. My thanks to Mr. Praful Shinde and Mr. Subir Das that we will continue to be nimble, Mr. Shinde, as we have been, and we'll continue to embark on a journey which will take us to higher heights. And Mr. Subir Das, I promise you that in West Bengal, we'll be continuing to do the innovation in the designing sector so that we are always one up to beat our competitors in the world per se. My thanks to Mr. Nilay Verma for conducting and moderating this session so very well that it doesn't seem that we have already spent almost 1.5 hour plus. But the way he has given chance to all the panelists, it seems that we are all enlightened more today as we walk out of this room today. Mr. B. Sarkar, thanks to you for announcing this from EPC side that you will be partnering with the private sector to do the facilitation center. And I'll be failing in my duty if I don't thank Mr. Arun Garodia for his opening remarks as to what that engineering is the future of West Bengal. Thanks to Mr. Bediwal for his wonderful remarks and my job has been made easier. Because if it had not been Mr. Rajiv Sinha and the department, the Foundry Park would have been left dream, because I am one of the possession. I have been given position in recently, and because of Mr. Rajiv Sinha, things have come so far. So, and my thanks to Mr. From Danieli, Mr. I'm sorry about that. But then you said that you have been here in the past, and you will continue to be here. And I promise you that you will continue to be here for a very, very long time, because as you rightly said, the steel is the demand of the steel takes care how much the country is developing, and we are on the growth path. India is the country, and West Bengal will be the pivotal in developing steel. So you can rest assured that you'll be here for a long time. And if the family is still not here, please get your family here. So wonderful. So Saturday, Sundays, you can play your golf, and then the business is forthcoming, and you will be exporting from here to all over the world. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. You know, as we say, we always save the best for the last, and it'll be my pleasure to invite Sri Rajiva Sinha ji for his comments, because we've heard so many things about his vision of driving this sector. So, welcome, sir.
Thank you very much, Nilay. First and foremost, I welcome our guest from Italy. And incidentally, I am also supposed to look after the Italian delegation to the convention. So there is a certain amount of bias you can understand. Thanks to all the panelists. At a short notice, they have come. And the banker and the banker sitting in the audience, that you have been able to announce something. Very small question. I thought that there will be a chance to ask questions to the ED of PNB. That where does, in the scheme of NPA and CGT SME and priority sector of MSE, does the issue of collateral come? I don't want to go beyond that, but if you are not sure about a venture, then only ask for guarantee. So if you are sure about a venture, why ask for a guarantee? And I would say, more than anything else, SME suffers because they could manage some money to set up a plant, but they cannot manage the collateral that is asked by the banks. So I would suggest that the government of West Bengal will be very happy to join hands with PNB and other banks in creating good project reports, in providing and facilitating all the linkages that as a banker and as an experienced person, you think that is required to start a venture. But then facilitation of something is different from asking for a guarantor. So you start with a feeling that you are going to fail, एंड दैट इज़ आई प्लीज़ गिव द गारंटी बिकॉज जब भाग जाइएगा तो आपका मकान हम बेच देंगे. सो आई एम सॉरी. या प्लीज
सर. एक्चुअली आई सेड दैट इट इज़ वन ऑफ द चैलेंज. अर्लियर बैंकर्स वेर ऑपरेटिंग इन दिस माइंड सेट दैट देयर शुड बी सम गारंटी एट लीस्ट टू इंश्योर दैट द मनी इज रिटर्न. Now, I think I have spoken this, that the government of India giving credit guarantee credit guarantee through CGTSME, and as well as bankers now focusing on cash flow, this requirement has been reduced. It is not being asked in these type of cases. So I think, sir, I have made it clear that bankers are now going all hog for loan to MSME, and primary security is always there. So we are open for financing MSME units based on their project report as well as viability.
Thank you very Thank much. You. We should not go much detail into it, but if ACS of the department says that all is well in my department, don't believe. it's the manager, district manager, and the industrial development officer, he has to be as good as the ACS is in order for the system to function. So whenever I talk to CMDs and EDs and general managers, everything is hunky-dory. But think of the poor manager sitting in Uluberia in one two-officer bank. It is difficult. But I take your word. Thank you very much for that. I especially request Mr. Khao to give some more time to Bengal, because it's a matter of privilege that the salt is coming to Bengal, and we have to take full advantage of that, since it is one of the world's largest design digital technology company. We should not miss out on that. And EPC is also setting up a design center in collaboration with them. So that is something which we should take advantage of in the foundry sector. Because whatever little I know about foundry, the technology is all digital technology, and what better agency than Dassault to be here. I also request the representative of Thermax and the other organization, L&T, to set base here. You know, aapka humne updesh suna sir, we heard your gyan, we heard your updesh. Now the convention is all about how much you invest here. So I will request EPC to request them to, you know, at least commit something that we are going to come back to Bengal and invest something here. And I think NID, our biggest design partner, the biggest institute of design in India, is going to be here. We are entering into an MOU with them today, and I'm sure we'll be able to take advantage of that. So, and Manufacturers Association representative, please help us in setting up this ancillary park. And
as a part of Indian Machine Tools Association, Bengal has been a destination which we aspire to. Point number two is coming from my organization, BFW. A corporate office, we belong to Bengal, so it's right here in Kolkata.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And Nila, I don't think I should thank you, because you are the knowledge partner. You are supposed to extract the best out of everyone here, but nonetheless KPMG has done a wonderful job, and thanks to all of you. My greatest worry was that 10 o'clock Rajarhat, how are you going to make it, but everybody made it except for me. So my apologies for that, and I welcome all of you to join the plenary session at 12 o'clock, which will be addressed by Honorable CM. Thank you very
Sir,
much.
Sir, before I let you go, if I could now request you to, just as a mark of appreciation, a gift to all our panelists for being here. They've been a wonderful panelist. If I could request you, if you can start with from this side. Mr. Anand Gopal. Mr. Vaishnav. Mr. Saran. Mr. Garodia. Mr. Khao.
Thank you very much, Mr. Sinha. Thank you
so much. Mr. Shende.
Thank you. Thank you.
Dr. Shubir Das. Mr. Sarkar. If I could also request Francisco, if you could join us. No, no.
Thank you.
Mr. Vijay.
Thank you.
Mr. Gore as well. I mean, you. I think he might have. Is there? Yeah, he is there.